something called exponential notation, which is just another way of naming a number like expanded notation was. So I'm going to show you a couple examples here and we'll talk about what's going on. The first one is expanded notation. We did this earlier, and that is where you take the digit times its place value and add those up. So we have 1 times 10,000 plus 2 times 1,000 plus 4 times 10 would be 12,040. Now, exponential notation does the exact same thing, as you can see now, except instead of writing all these zeros, we could actually write it as an exponent like we've been working on. So 1 times 10,000 would be written as 1 times 10 to the fourth power. Remember, there are four zeros here, so that would be 10 to the fourth power. The 2 times the 1,000 would be 2 times 10 to the third power because of the three zeros. And 4 times 10 would be just 4 times 10 to the first power because there's just one zero. Okay, so exponential notation is actually exactly like expanded notation, except you're using exponents. That's why they call it exponential. So let's try one more here. We have 3,050,700. So the expanded notation would be 3 times 1,000,000 plus 5 times 10,000 plus 7 times 100. So now if you wanted to do that with exponential notation, you would just do 3 times 10 to the 6th power, because remember there's 6 zeros, plus 5 times 10 to the 4th power, plus 7 times 10 to the 2nd power. Now, a couple things that people have wondered in the past is, like for the 1's place, the 1's place would be 10 to the 0 power, because there are no zeros in 1, okay? Something else too, the reason why people like to do this method as compared to this method is because it's much shorter. You don't have to do as many zeros. Another trick is this, if you want to figure out what exponent to use. So here, 3 times 10 to the 6th power means there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. Or you could look up here where the 3 is, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers after the 3. If I looked at the 5, which is right here, we'll do it in blue, notice that there's 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers after the 5. So that's where we went with the 4. And then if you looked at the 7, there's 1, 2 numbers after the 7. So that's why we went with a 2 right here as well. So that's just another trick to figure that out. So that's how you do expanded notation to name big numbers.